Yes, sir. What's going down, everybody? It's your boy Onto the Boss here. And last episode, we started my sophomore season. And in this episode, we'll be covering week 2 to 4, I believe, of my sophomore season. Now, one thing that is necessary to all episodes is keep you guys updated with the top 25 polls. Oklahoma is number one. You got USC, who doesn't have Mac Barkley this season. Obviously, he entered the NFL draft. Alabama, Wisconsin, no surprise there. And then surprisingly, Georgia is number 5 this year. Arkansas, Utah, TCU is at number 8. And you got Michigan and Oregon at number 10. Here's the Heisman watch. We are coming off of a Heisman win, obviously, my freshman season. And right now, things are looking pretty good as well, entering my sophomore season. So here's week number 2. This one's going to be against Temple. We played them last season, and here we are again. Last time we lost to them, but we are trying to pick up a victory in this one. Things get started here with a handoff to the right side, and I had nowhere to go there as the defenders get me down, but then the quarterback is going to find me for a first down right here as I get a reception. Then once again, I'm going to call for the ball, but the quarterback decides to throw it to the receiver, and this ball is going to get intercepted, and Temple is going to go up by a touchdown. But we're trying to get a drive going here once again, and we are in our opponent's territory. Quarterback is going to step back one more time, and he is going to get this reception to go down. For those that missed it, here is the angle. The receiver caught it near the end zone, near the out of bounds mark, but he was still able to hold on to it and take it in for the end zone. So Temple is still up by 7 points. We are into the third quarter. We're trying to tie things up again. It seems like the defense is not getting any stops in this one. My quarterback is going to step back, just fling this one to the right side of the field and tie things up. So late in the game, Temple is up by 4 points, and with 3 minutes remaining, you know, we're not worried at all here, because all we have to do is pretty much waste time, because I don't want the ball to be on Temple's hands late in the game, knowing what my defense could do. So we're trying to waste some time and you know, pretty much have the last possession of the game. So I get a catch right here. I am stopped just short. We have no timeout with 7 seconds remaining. Quarterback is gonna step back, throw it to the right side of the field. And in week number 2, you know, even in week number 1, everything came down to the last minute. It doesn't get any more clutch than this as we pick up back-to-back victories here in week number 2 with the score of 31-28. So I'm loving it so far. 2-0 record. We have some tough matchups coming up, actually. And week number 3, this one is going to be against the 2-0 North Carolina team. ACC conference matchup. So here we go. Let's start this one as well. And we get started here in the first quarter. Our first possession. And it seems like this sophomore season, I worked on my catching more than I did my rushing. But you are going to see a lot of rushing plays in this one as well. So one handoff right there for first down. Here is another one where I am just 3 yards shy of a first down. So why not? Let's run the same play right here. First and goal now. Everybody is loving it. The sideline is on fire. And with third and goal here, I am going to take this one into the end zone for the first touchdown of the game. So North Carolina, they get the ball. They can't really do anything. We're here. We're trying to attack. I call for the ball here, and a mistake on my part for calling it too early. And the defensive end is going to take this one for the touchdown. So North Carolina, they get the ball back once again. They make it 14-7. We're going to run this screenplay right here. This one should take me to the end zone. But oh wait, I am just short of a touchdown, but that is no problem because my quarterback, his confidence has been skyrocketed in the last couple weeks. He's going to step back and throw that touchdown. So things are tied up. We are into the third quarter. Quarterback is going to do a couple handoffs, which is going to, you know, lead us into the opposing team's 10-yard line. And already 16 rushes, 114 yards. One more handoff right here is gonna give us the lead. So North Carolina, no problem for them. They tie things up. So it is fourth quarter now. Every possession is gonna count. I get a huge yardage right there, and then another handoff here where I break a couple tackles, and I am a yard short of a first down. So what do we do here? Another handoff. There's a lot of people ahead of me, you know, trying to block me out, but yep, that was not a problem as I go in for another touchdown. So it's going to be pretty interesting to see what North Carolina is going to do here as I, you know, give my team the lead late in the fourth quarter. So let's see what North Carolina will do. Of course, they tie it up, but we have 1 minute to work with here. Quarterback is going to go deep as my receiver burns the secondary and takes this one to the house. So back-to-back weeks, you know, week one through three, it hasn't gotten any more clutch than this. We're doing it both offensively and defensively. Here in week number three, we keep our undefeated season going with the score of 35-28. So we take care of North Carolina, and then another tough matchup on our way. We got West Virginia, and I was really shocked right here because taking a look at West Virginia's record, 0-3, and that tells you a lot about how much talent they probably lost to the draft, you know. Their running backs, probably receivers, all gone to the draft. And Tavon Austin, probably one of them that, you know, already declared for the NFL draft. He's gone from Virginia. And you see the ACC Conference 3-0, we are second. And here's something that I want to show you guys, the toughest places to play. Obviously, here's 1 through 10. And then I was trying to find, you know, the Byrd Stadium, the Maryland Terp Stadium. And we are only 49th with a C-minus grade. But, you know, we're going to turn that around as the season goes. So here is week number 4 against the University of West Virginia. So we're going to try to keep things going. You know, we have a lot of success on the season so far. We're undefeated. So, you know, 0-3 Virginia, we're not worried about these guys. So we're going to pound the ball on them. You see that one huge yardage I got earlier from the play. And now I am just short of a first down. So one catching play right here. But that one is not going to work out. So West Virginia's defense was on point in the first half. And now we are in the third quarter, you know. Struggling and stuck, you know, what is going on? Why are we struggling against an 0-3 team? So we decided to turn things around. I get a huge rushing play right here, and we have 3 minutes to work with in the third quarter. Quarterback is going to step back. He's going to go deep. And once again on fourth down, on third down, should I say, we are stopped short. So we settle for a field goal on that possession. But then right as we get the ball back, I take this one to the house and only make it a 4-point game. So, hey, everyone is sitting back here and thinking, uh-oh, it's going to be another close game, another week where it's going to come down to the last second. So, in the third quarter, you know, West Virginia hasn't scored a point yet. But as soon as I said that, my quarterback throws an interception to the cornerback, and he takes this one to the end zone. So we are trailing by 11 points. What is going to happen here? My quarterback decides to, you know, put the team on his back with 3 minutes remaining. He gets a quarterback carry right here for a huge gain, and then he's going to step back, nowhere to go to, and he's going to take this one in by himself. So it's 24-16. It's an 8-point game. Anything is possible here. We have a minute to work with, and we are now down to the last 30 seconds. My quarterback is going deep. This one is a reception for a touchdown, but we still have to go for two. Let's see what's going to happen here. My quarterback hikes the ball. He steps back. He could take off, but he decides to throw it to the left side of the field. And this one is probably, you know, considering the speed of my quarterback, going to be taken to the house. And just like that, West Virginia gets 2 points on that play because it was a point after. They don't really get a touchdown. They get 2 points credited to them. And with us having no timeouts, that is pretty much it. West Virginia gets their first victory of the season. We get our first loss. 3-1 record. I'm not too disappointed. Things are still looking good as we lose this one 26-22.